give you back a beat all this morning. Let's all just stand up and worship together today. Sometimes you gotta dance through the darkness, sing through the fire, praise when it don't make sense. Sometimes you gotta stare down the giant, worship from the lion's den. Sometimes you gotta shout it from the mountain, louder in the valley, trust he's gonna get you there. Sometimes you gotta welcome the wonder, wait for the answer, worship with your hands in the air. I'll praise you anywhere. Out together this morning. He's been faithful.
Been faithful all my life, blessings day and night, countless reasons why. I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath. I'll praise you anywhere. Faithful all my life, blessings day and night, countless reasons why. I'll praise you anywhere. Every promise kept, goodness every step, each and every breath. I'll praise you anywhere. Praise, giving praise, giving praise in the highest. Praise, giving praise, giving praise in the highest. There's nothing to fear now, for I am safe with you.
So when I fight on my knees with my hands lifted high. Oh God, the battle belongs to you, and every fear I lay at your feet. I'll sing through the night. Oh God, the battle belongs to you.
And if you are for me, who can be against me? For Jesus, there's nothing impossible for you.
When all I see are the ashes, you see the beauty. When all I see is a cross, God, you see the empty tomb.
Y'all can have a seat.
All right, Remy, I want you to come up here with me for a second. Yes, you. We didn't get to do something yesterday for you because you had to leave early. So I know it. That's why we're bringing it up. So yesterday, me and this little girl here and her mother actually shared the same birthday. Well, they sang, yeah, you can give it up. This is Remy. Oh, she's showing off. Can you see her ears glistening over here? They're sparkly. She has new sparklies in there. So how old were you yesterday?
Good.
How old were you?
Six.
6 years old. So can we sing happy birthday to Remy while she's up here? And you don't want me starting it, and you don't want Zoe starting it. So we want to get somebody. No, I'm just kidding. She was asking me yesterday, you go back down there with your family. She was asking me yesterday, are you going to sing happy birthday to me today? And I'm like, we will. But she had to end up leaving before we had a chance. So we sang happy birthday to Jesse, and they sang happy birthday to me. But we are glad you guys are here, whether it's your birthday or not. So if you want to find out who others' birthdays or whatever else is going on, you can text your information to that number, 502-694-2180. We'll add you to the list, send out whether it's the worship folder, financial information, upcoming events, different things like that. So we do have a picture that we just finished. If some of us are dragging, we just finished with Revolution Weekend last night. So starting on Friday night, about 6, we had somewhere around 25 students and adults, went to about 9:30, then started back the next morning about 8, went to about 6 last night. And I do want to share one thing, because our whole goal when we do things like this is not only to tell our students about Jesus, but we do an incentive too for whoever has the most students show up the next morning for small groups, they get a pizza party. Now, Miranda told me, because I said that Ann and I would take them out, that discouraged them from wanting to come. So I don't know if that's why they didn't show up this morning or not. So I thought it was an incentive to go out to eat with Ann and myself. But, so the middle school guys, unfortunately, they had 0 show up for small groups. So Peyton, going to have to work a little harder next time on you and your buddies to get here for small groups. The middle school girls, Zoe represented them, but they only had 17% of the middle school girls. The high school girls, they were better. They had 57% show up today, so good job, ladies. But my high school guys, where are they? Yes, back there, 67% of them were here, so Malachi and Corday. And they don't mind going out to eat with Ann and I, so don't listen to Miranda. It's actually all right. So, but for everybody else that was here, whether it was adults, I don't know, Daniel, Wendy, Justin, Miranda, they were here the whole time, and the band playing the 2 times. So just a great weekend. We had a lot of fun. So if you're on Facebook, you can see some of the pictures, but that's just one of the ones from worship, one of the nights. Speaking of feeling old, if you are 50 or older, that doesn't mean you're old, but you can come to the Senior Adult Fellowship Luncheon on Tuesday at noon. So right back there in the Fellowship Hall, we're having soup. And so if you want to bring something that goes along with soup, or if you want to bring your own soup, I guess. But it's always a good time. Sharon will be sharing a devotion. And usually it lasts about an hour, hour and a half, something like that. Mugs and Muffins continue. This is with the ladies, so on the 24th at 9:30. So next Saturday, or this coming Saturday at 9:30 in the Fellowship Hall, that's for your ladies. This is our Easter egg hunt, and this is really more just to put in your calendars, just so that you know what's going on. We'll have some inflatables. You like that? Everett? Everett, you think that'll be good? Yes. So we could use some candy. So if you're out and about, if you want to pick up some nut-free candy and something small enough to fit in, like those 3-inch eggs or whatever they are, we're going to start filling eggs on Wednesday nights. So we kind of do a little bit as we work up to the 30th. So that'll be a cool time. So, all right, and there's your different ways to give. There's a box outside or an iPad down the hallway. You can go online or you can text it to that number there as well. So let me pray, and then we got... we'll dismiss our kids to. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you and just thankful that we can gather at any day of the week, any time, Lord, with those others that are seeking you, and Lord, for the opportunities that you give us, just to be able to share Jesus with maybe those that have never heard about you before. Lord, so we thank you for that. Lord, I pray today as we continue to worship through song, Lord, and I pray as Matt gets up here to share the word shortly that you would speak through him. Lord, be with those elementary students as they go out to love on you as well. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, so my kindergartners through fifth grade, you are following Jade and Sandy. So the rest of you guys get to stay in here and worship with us.
Let's stand and worship together again this morning.
I
is crowned with glory now. The Savior knelt to wash our feet. Now at his feet we bow. The one who wore our sin and shame, now robed in majesty. The shines for all to see. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King. Your name is victory. There would not remain. Satan's wrong, boom, great. Our God is wrong, boom, great. Yeah. Your name is victory. All praise will rise to Christ our King.
Just come before you this morning, and I just thank you for bringing us all here together to just worship you in your house this morning. And I just pray right now over Matt as he brings your word this morning. I pray that you speak through him and just open our hearts to receive what you have to say. And it's in your name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church. How are we? You know, I like it off to the side a little bit. Hey, We're good. We're good. Okay. I know that's just something you say. Like at work, you pass in the halls, and you're like, "How are you? Good. How are you? Good." But really, are we good? Okay. That's all that matters. Today, we're in John 14. If you'll turn to your Bibles, I have some verses on the slides and some not on the slides. So you have to read your Bible, darn. The title of the sermon today is Help is on the Way, and I meant to bring my Catboy mask. I really thought about that this morning. Our son Everett will be four this year. We're really into Thomas the Train and Paw Patrol and PJ Masks. I meant to wear my mask today, but we're talking about the Holy Spirit, so he's kind of everywhere, not really in a mask form. But I am glad you guys could be here today. I do have to be honest, this year, 2024, has been tough. It seems like I have spent way too much time at a funeral home. I don't know about you, but I dislike being there more than I like being there. I have had the incredible opportunity to lead a service for my wife, Sandy, her cousin, Trent. He did pass away late last year. I had the opportunity to talk about him and his life and just talk about just what we expect or what we can hope for in the days ahead in our lives, having lost loved ones. I know it's hard. I've lost loved ones. I've lost people that I've just met and things like that. And it is just, it's hard. Life can be hard. Help is on the way, but here we are still living our lives with our lost loved ones, with our loved ones that we have, with our new loved ones about to be born. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for those that have lost loved ones or have lost people, but there is a future of happiness and joy ahead of us. There is comfort in the arms of Jesus. Jesus and the hope for eternal life in heaven with him. I can only hope that my words today and those words at the funerals, Lord, that they just bring you comfort. I just thank you for being here. I thank you all for being here, and I hope we are good. Today, we are going to talk about the book of John. The book of John is awesome. Is just awesome. I read through the Bible a couple years ago straight through. It took me 256 days, I don't know. But when I came to the book of John, as a Christian, I was excited. I knew that the book of John is something that we all look forward to reading. And my goodness, it was so awesome. We are in John 14 today. There are 21 chapters in John, so we've still got a ways to go. A couple weeks ago, I worked on our YouTube channel, put all of our John sermons in a list. This week will be 41 weeks in John, so I hope you're ready for, 7 or 8 or 9 or 10 or 15 more weeks of John. John is awesome. It's one of my favorite books of the Bible. We get to see a lot of Jesus' life. A lot of his miracles that he performed, a lot of interactions with Jesus and the disciples. There is also the absolutely brutal description and depiction of Jesus' crucifixion. The book of John is one of the most impactful books in the Bible if you want to learn about Jesus. Daniel spoke at our Revolution weekend that we had the opportunity to be at, and it was a lot of fun. Daniel talked about if you're a new Christian or if you want to learn about Jesus, start with Matthew. I thought he was going to say start with Matthew, then Mark, then Luke, then John. But he said start with Matthew. You get some miracles. You get some the Great Commission, and you get the Beatitudes and things like that. But then move to John. Daniel said that there is something about John as a Christian, as you read it, you just feel the presence of Jesus as you read it. You are just warmed to your soul reading it. I highly recommend reading the book of John on your own. If you do have questions, we have some awesome pastors that you can ask. Some of them are here today. Some are preaching at other churches. But we do have some awesome and smart pastors that are very helpful in that situation. I also recommend praying. If you have questions, pray. We have the through line to God. If you have questions, you can pray. It has been very helpful in my reading of the Bible. So, as I said, we're in John 14, but 14 chapters, let's go back a few and recap. So we're going to recap a few sections, a few chapters of our recent time in the book of John. As I said, the book of John is heavy. It is heavy, both in the impact that it has on our faith, and there's a lot of doctrine. I love doctrine. I love theologians and theology. The book of John has a lot of that. There are a lot of things that also lead to the functions in our churches today, the Lord's Supper and different things like that. So let's bring you up to speed on the last few chapters that we've read. John 10, and I've got them all up here. John 10. Jesus as the good shepherd. Jesus identifies himself as the good shepherd who cares for his sheep and lays down his life for them. John 10 also, Jesus as the Son of God. The religious leaders question Jesus about his identity, but Jesus asserts his divine relationship with the Father. John 11. Bibles. Soon the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Since I live, you also will live. Thank you. Let's read that again. Verse 19. Soon the world will no longer see me, but you will see me. Since I live, you also will live. Let me say that one more time, just so you can get, since I live, you also will live. Thanks, honey. The life of a Christian always depends on the life of Christ. Jesus, without Christ, there would be no eternal life. Jesus says in John 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Since I live, you also will live. I could stop right there. We're almost at noon. I might want to get you out early, but we've got some more verses to go. And as I said, everything is important. So we're going to read verses 20 through 26 here in your Bibles. Okay, here we go. When I am raised to life again, you will know that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. Those who accept my commandments and obey them are the ones who love me. And because they love me, my Father will love them. And I will love them and reveal myself to each of them. Judas, not Judas Iscariot, but the other disciple with that name, said to him, Lord, why are you going to reveal yourself only to us and not to the world at large? Jesus replied, all who love me will do what I say. My Father will love them, and we will come and make our home with each of them. Anyone who doesn't love me will not obey me. And remember, my words are not my own. What I am telling you is from the Father who sent me. I am telling you these things now while I am still with you. But when the Father sends the Advocate as my representative, that is the Holy Spirit, he will teach you everything and will remind you of everything that I have told you. Let's look at verse 26 here. Jesus was saying to his disciples, and the effect of the Holy Spirit was upon them. It is clear from many gospel passages that the disciples didn't understand the ultimate meaning of Christ's teaching regarding his death, burial, and resurrection. And I can say it's pretty hard for us too. These 2,000 years ahead, it's pretty hard for us to understand the ultimate meaning of Christ's death, burial, and resurrection. But to continue, after Jesus' resurrection, the Holy Spirit comes upon the disciples in Acts. But Jesus said that the Holy Spirit will teach you things. And on that day at Pentecost in Acts, that we'll read in Acts, the disciples understood what was happening regarding Jesus and especially the meaning of his death and resurrection. For us today, the Holy Spirit illuminates the Bible for us. It can be confusing, but we have faith and we have the helper that is the Holy Spirit to illuminate the Bible for us. At the moment of salvation, the Holy Spirit dwells in you, and we are given a new heart. Ezekiel 36 says that. As the Lord told Israel, and I will put my spirit in you and move you to follow my decrees and be careful to keep my laws. That's Ezekiel. Jesus is telling us that the Holy Spirit is coming. Without the Holy Spirit enabling us to understand the Bible and God's commands, we cannot understand or obey them. Paul clearly states in the reality in 1 Corinthians, if you've read 1 Corinthians, this is what we speak, not in the words taught to us by human wisdom, by simple pastors, not taught to us by human wisdom, but taught to us by the Holy Spirit, explaining spiritual realities with Spirit-taught words. The person without the Spirit does not accept these things that come from the Spirit of God, but considers them foolish and cannot understand them because they are discerned only through the Spirit. Today, the Holy Spirit enables us to understand, to live out and to apply God's word in our lives. We might say that that's a little bit easier said than done, but that's why we're the sinners and we have the perfect Savior and the Holy Spirit living with us, ready to bring us home to Him. We are the wretched, disgusting sinners, and we have a perfect Savior and Holy Spirit living with us, ready to bring us home. Just a few more verses, and I've only got five more pages of notes. So we're going to read verses 27 through 31 here. 27 through 31. Here we go. Red letters. Jesus talking to the disciples. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give you is the gift the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Remember what I told you. I am going away, and I will come back to you again. If you really loved me, you would be happy that I am going to the Father, who is greater than I am. I have told you these things before they happen, so that when they do happen, you will believe. I don't have much time to talk to you because the ruler of the world approaches. He has no power over me, but I will do what the Father requires of me, so that the world will know that I love the Father. Come. Let's be going. So, verse 27 here, the gift. I am leaving you with a gift, peace of mind and a heart. And the peace I give you is a gift that the world cannot give. So don't be troubled or afraid. Jesus brings the disciples back to the topic of peace in their turmoil. Peace is more than the absence of strife. Peace refers to well-being and blessing. Jesus blesses his disciples and his followers today with this peace, with his peace. The peace that the world gives is dependent on life's circumstances. As I asked you this morning, are you good? That's dependent on life's circumstances. This phrase gets tossed around. Happiness is based on happenings, where joy is not based on circumstances, like peace. To have Christ's peace is to be in a right relationship with Christ. How is that possible? How is it possible to be in a right relationship with Christ? Well, that's a great question. The best known verse in all of the Bible, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, for whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." What's important there is believing in him. How do we do that? Well, I've got it broken down for you pretty simply. To believe in Jesus includes a wholehearted trust in him for the forgiveness of your sins. You also need to forsake your sins and repent. Forsake, you need to get rid of them. You know what they are. You know what they are. Each and every one of you know what your sins are. Today, you don't want me to say them because you know what they are. You will be convicted by the Holy Spirit that you need to forgive and forsake your sins. Christ will bring forgiveness if you forsake your sins. You need to wholeheartedly trust Jesus for the forgiveness of your sins and forsake your sins and repent. As we can read in Mark 1:15, all who truly repent or turn from your sins and believe in Jesus for the forgiveness of your sins will be redeemed and restored to a right relationship with Christ. Jesus requires also putting trust in Jesus. Jesus requires trust. Jesus is not just a person. He is not just a man in ancient times, but he is our Savior living today at the right hand of the Father. We have the opportunity to communicate with him today. He's not just a person. These things, to believe in Jesus is to wholeheartedly trust in him. for the forgiveness of your sins. You have to decide to forsake your sins. We are not of this world. We are hopefully going to be with Jesus in heaven, but we have to do these things first. We have to do these things first. I could continue, but if you do have questions, like I said, we do have some awesome pastors that can help you. If you have questions about this, if you're excited to believe in Christ, this is it. If you are in Children's Church, you can accept, believe, confess, and you can trust God as your Savior. Let's keep going. We have a few more verses here. Belief. Verses 28 and 29. Remember what I told you. I am going away, but I will come back to you again. If you really loved me, you would be happy that I am going to the Father, who is greater than I am. I have told you these things before they happen, so that when they happen, you will believe. Here again, the disciples have no fear, Jesus' talk of his departure. If the disciples knew what this truly meant, Jesus going to the cross, they would be rejoicing. Jesus' purpose in telling them these things and telling us these things is so that we have faith in him and be strengthened when these things take place. Verse 30 and 31, the ruler of the world. I don't have much time to talk to you because the ruler of the world approaches. He has no power over me, but I will do what the Father requires of me so that the world will know that I love the Father. Come, let's be going. Now, this ruler of the world, I remember I was going to ask a question. I needed a response. Who do you think is the ruler of the world? And you can shout it out. Yeah, good. That was easy. You guys got it. Satan, yeah. Okay. Satan is coming. In the Gospel of John, Satan is coming in the person of Judas and those with him. This is why in a short time, Jesus will no longer talk with them. I don't have much time to talk to you. Jesus is not subject to Satan. Satan has no claim on Jesus. Satan has no claim on us if we have Jesus. Satan can't force Jesus to do anything, but Jesus is willingly subjects to the suffering that is to come out of obedience to the Father. Jesus willingly subjects himself to the suffering that is to come out of the obedience to the Father. Jesus subjects himself to this suffering that is to come for us, so that we can live with him in heaven forever. He willingly submits himself to suffering for us. Jesus' obedience to the Father signifies his love for the Father and to us. Now, we talked about the Holy Spirit, and we talked about these references. I think you've got it. But we do have references here. If you want to read those, go ahead and read those. I'll hand them out after the class. Whatever. Those who do not believe do not have the Spirit. Scripture often uses the expression the world in reference to the fallen nature of man, which rejects God. But those who believe in Christ know him. And they know the way to salvation. That is through Christ. Those who reject Christ don't see Christ, and they don't see God. They don't know God, and they are lost. The promise of the Holy Spirit is what we talked about today, but to have the Holy Spirit as our helper, as our paracletus, is to have God himself living in us as believers. The Spirit teaches us the Word and guides us in truth. The Spirit reminds us that Jesus has taught us so that we can depend on the Word in difficult times. The Spirit works in us to give us peace, to give us Christ's love, to give us Christ's joy. The Spirit comforts our hearts and minds in a troubled world. The power of the Paracletus gives us the ability by the Spirit not to gratify the desires of this world. The Spirit can produce His fruit in our lives. There are things, the spirit, the different spirits of the thing. The fruit of the Spirit is what we have because of the Holy Spirit. To glorify God the Father. What a blessing it is for us to have the Holy Spirit live in our lives as our comforter, as our encourager, as our counselor, and our advocate. And how do we receive the Holy Spirit? Let's go through it one more time. Wholeheartedly trust in Jesus for the forgiveness of our sins. We have to do that. We have to do that. And we have to forsake our sins, forsake this world for Christ. Because he, as we said, he submitted himself to utter suffering for us. That's all I got. Let's pray, and then we'll continue. We've got another song. Thank you, guys. God's awesome. Let's pray. I need a second. Heavenly Father, Lord, I thank you so much for all that you do for us, Lord. I thank you for giving us this helper, for giving us the Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you for living within us. Lord, I pray that your words today spoke to someone, Lord. I pray that they understood your words, Lord, thankful to the Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray for us. I pray as we continue throughout our lives, Lord, focused on you and learning more about you, Lord. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you. It's in your awesome and wonderful name that we pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you please stand? We'll have some pastors at the corner if you'd like to.
God, how I need you. righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. It's your my one defense, my righteousness. Oh God, how I need you.
Well, we just come before you this morning and just we just love you, Father, and just as your word said this morning, that the peace of the Holy Spirit and just that peace that only you can give, Father, that we truly, we need that. We need that every hour of every day. I just pray that we just realize that. We just lean into your love and lean into your peace just as we go into this crazy and hectic world that we live in, Father. We just trust in you. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Y'all have a great week. We'll see you next time.